CEMADONTV. CEMADONTV. CEMADONTV.
Reaching. You have something to share with people. Maybe your anniversary, your wedding, your birthday. Can you please tell me those you give your invitation cards to? Are they your enemies or your friends? Yeah, it is expected that we give our invitation cards to our friends. Jesus loves you so much. And today, that is the part of the Bible that gives me joy. Jesus has invited you and I to come. I'm inviting you. Especially those of you who are overladen with worries. Those who are weighed down by circumstances, predicaments of life. They come. I will help you. I will give you rest. You are troubling yourself so much. If only you can come to me, I will give you rest. You invite those you love. And he loves us so much. You can see the sign of love there. He died for you. But unfortunately in our society, we don't listen to him. We don't understand. We don't even know how to answer this great invitation. Because we don't even know what we are expecting. But I want to quickly tell you what will happen. When you graciously respond to the invitation of Jesus Christ, will you respond positively? He said, I will give you rest. I will give you rest. What kind of rest? The word rest carries four powerful, completed, perfect blessings. And that is what everybody desires, including me. So the word of God says, come to me. All you are overburdened, all you are troubled, and I will give you rest. Okay, then I know. Can somebody please, if everybody now, everybody, let us spell the word rest. And the arm there stands for restoration. See it, everybody.
Restoration.
Now, when God says, come to me, all you are overburdened, and I will give you rest, he's telling you, I will restore that thing in you that the enemy stole. He's telling you, come to me. I know you are down. I know you are broken. I will restore your love life. I will restore your finances. I will restore your business. I will restore your relationship. If only you can come to me. So the rest there means you will have peace. Because that thing that belongs to you, that the enemy stole, that the enemy destroyed, God says, I will restore. Let me give you an example of what restoration is. We all know our brother in the scripture, Mr. Job. You all know the story of Job. You saw how the devil dealt with Job. Many of us have been dealt with by the devil. The enemy dealt with Job, fought him, destroyed everything that Job ever had in life, afflicted him with sickness. Job lost his good health, lost his billions, lost his beauty, lost even their children. What a wicked devil we have. Devil is very wicked, you know. I'm telling you, that is why I will forever fight the devil. But you know the funniest thing, devil is very powerful and he can easily make you fall. He made Jesus fall. Jesus fell 3 times. But with God, we can conquer the devil in Jesus' name. So number one, restoration. When God restored the blessings of Job, you all know the story that Job's blessings became better than what the enemy took away. So I pray for anyone here who is heavenly bodied, that the enemy has stolen or destroyed what belongs to you. As I lift up Jesus during the sacrifice of the Mass, may all that the enemy took from you be restored in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What is the second letter for the word rest?
E.
One letter. That E stands for enlargement. Somebody say enlargement.
Enlargement.
And I know you know what it means. That is growth. When you have a beautiful picture, you will tell your photographer to do what? Maybe during your graduation, they snapped you, and then you saw one. You look like an angel. Your nose in order. You were breathing well during the time. Your limbs well packaged. And then with the uniform you're wearing, well organized. The cape is in order. And then you look at yourself, you smile. There was fulfillment in you. There was satisfaction in you. You call the photographer and say, this particular one, do what?
Enlarge
it. Then you come to me, all of you who have been deleted. That wonderful thing about you is not growing. Your business is not growing. Your marriage is not growing. Your relationship is not growing. Come, let me enlarge it. For the past 10 years, you have been in one room and one parlor. You need a flat. Come on, let me enlarge you. Is there anything in you you want to enlarge? Only one thing, I give you only 60 seconds. Tell God what you want in your life. You must learn to pray. Tell God, Lord, and life. My relationship with Peter, and God, and God, and God, and God, my relationship, my master. Let me entrust your responsibilities upon me. My
chance to walk in you, and you have peace, the peace, the war.
not die in death life. You will not rot in death life. May God never allow anyone here to rot in death life. Death fire is not your home, and can never be your home. If you believe, lift up your hands and say, love amen. And the last letter for the wonderful blessing was E. Again. That T stands for total victory. Total victory. God wants to follow you. But you will enjoy holistic victory. Holistic, total victory. Come and follow God. No, we won't pass the resurrection for us, man. You will enjoy total victory. You will enjoy total victory. I'm telling you, the word of God gave us a wonderful testimony about King David. David followed God so much, even though he committed sin some days, he won the heart of God in total fellowship, that he was described as a man after God's own heart. As if that is not enough, David called God his shepherd. And many of us love that psalm. Many of us pray the psalm and we read it. Even though we don't pray, we read it. And we see the way he has described his relationship with God that gave him total victory. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. I don't need anybody to shepherd me again. He said, in this thing, to greener pastures, I know that my tomorrow will be better than my yesterday. He leads me and he says, sometimes we pass through the shadow of death and my faith is broken. But I am not scared because I know that God is with me. I know that God is with me. You know, sometimes when you see false preachers preach about God, I don't know, maybe sometimes we don't give you the right impression about ourselves. Maybe we try to make you know that we are superhumans. Maybe we try to let you know that our tears are not existing again. No. You know that I cry. Sometimes things go bad around me. I have to call on God and say, God, where are you? I kneel down by the side of my bed. I shed tears. My 19 years as a priest, I will not tell you it's all roses. I shed tears and said, God, where are you? Did you not say you will be with me? Do not allow my enemies to laugh at me. Do not allow those who are saying, let us see how we will survive, laugh at me. And I shed tears before God. And then when I come before you, I talk like a warrior. And you want to become a warrior automatically. Not knowing that this man also has tears. There are times when you must shed tears. I'm having a program next week at Abro at the Ghana City for women. I tap it. The power of the tears of a praying woman. There is power in tears. Exodus chapter 3, the Lord said, I have seen the tears of my people. If you know you are here and you are a man 40 years, 50 years, and you have never shed tears before God, sorry for you. You are fake. You are not real. See what others are doing. Can you do that? Look at how your responsibilities are around your head. Even when many of us pretend, you know that your mother and your father is supposed to be receiving salary from you. You don't know. You don't know that your mother and your father is supposed to be receiving salary from you. You are supposed to be paying them. Gratuity for taking care of you, for nurturing you, for investing in you. It is not charity. It is more than charity. It is responsibility. Your father is not receiving monthly allowing. You are a failure. Especially when you have reached the age. No matter, I didn't tell you like more than 20 billion. Whether you are receiving the salary of 20,000 naira, you must pay your mother the gratuity, the interest. of the money they use in training in the university. Your pocket money, revision money, name it, accommodation and feeding. Total victory when Christ is your rock. So I pray for all of you this evening that we may have the passion and the desire to respond to the invitation of Jesus Christ. And so doing, may we enjoy rest. Now, what is rest? Number one. Two. Three. The last. If you are interested in this form, say amen three times.